Bradley McDougal are going to be back. This year's number one of the Big 12 on kick returns at almost 34. And talked about it starting back at 1902, and we are underway in Lawrence. Bashir's over to the side, and it did get into the end zone. A touchback, and what a kick by Cantelli to take out a very dangerous weapon early in this game, kind of like Corby Jones was for the Missouri Tigers.
I'll tell you, Corby Jones, you talk about the original of the dual threat guys. Corby Jones, man, can beat you with the feet and beat you with the throwing arm.
Up in the booth with us tonight on this special edition of College Football Saturday. So, unfortunately, a Wildcat is down and injured early in this game. That's Charles Melton, the defensive back, redshirt freshman out of Manhattan. So important, though, for Kansas coming off, and both teams coming off real tough losses where they were not a factor. It was last Thursday, a week ago tonight, for Kansas State. They were pounded at home, and then basically embarrassed was the Kansas Jayhawks, and that was on the road last week. Dave, you were there against the Baylor Bears.
2 weeks ago, they had a bye week, but it was 2 weeks ago down in Waco, Joel, and it was 55-7. It was just a speed mismatch. And you talk about taking the ball out of the hands of a speed merchant. DJ Bashir's number one in the conference, and he's fourth in the nation in kickoff returns, and take it right out of his hands. Bill Snyder showing the concern for his fallen soldier.
And what that graphic does not tell you is his success against the Kansas Jayhawks.
Right.
14-4 and his first 18 matchups.
You know,
that is Oney, your chief rival. And here comes Jordan Webb, the redshirt freshman that we were talking about. St. Louis area young man out of Union, Missouri. He threw just one interception in 93 attempts over the first four games before throwing two in the game we were just talking about at Baylor. And he's got a true freshman in the backfield in James Sims. So here we go. Finally, ready to go in Lawrence. It'll be Sims. Little zone read, and he spins for five straight up the gut. And offensively, we saw Jordan Webb. Jeremiah Hatch is his anchor, and I mean that more than just being a center, because he is the experience up front, a three-year starter on the offensive line. The senior from Houston, as you look at the backs and receivers, Jonathan Wilson. He is an outstanding receiver. As coming back on it, Wilson on cue. Gets their first down of the contest in the rivalry game, and he's up to about the 32. Brought down by Sweeney. Defensively, in our Phillips Television starting lineups, the first 11, Brandon Harold's the playmaker in their 4-2-5. They'll go with three to start tonight. Rebeck, the experienced, the junior from St. Louis at linebacker, second season starter. And Sweeney and Tyson Hartman, their strong safety, their best in the secondary. Honorable mention all Big 12 for Tyson Hartman last year.
Going up tempo, Joel. Both first downs, they've gone two tight end set.
Tony's son, Deshaun Sands. Tony Sands, second all-time leading rusher at Kansas. His son cracks it up the middle for about three and a half. And now, Dave, coming in our keys to the game presented by Chrysler for the young Jayhawks.
Well, they want to be plus two in the turnover department. They only have three takeaways. They got to get more takes, less than or equal to 10. That means no more than 10 missed tackles in the game, 80 plus. That means pancake blocks, knockdown blocks. When they've knocked people down 80, 85 times in the game, they've gotten their wins. Whoa, a little early
on the left side, you think?
Yeah.
Brad Thornton coming up, the tackle over on that side. Five-yard mark off on second down. We'll be second and long.
Everybody's going NASCAR up tempo, and sometimes it can hurt you. You know, you get a tight end coming off the ball, wing back coming off, or a tackle coming off the ball, wing back coming off the ball too soon. Going to set you back. Now you're behind the chains.
Yeah, they were trying to do a little wildcat. Bashir's in the flat, and it's dropped. So they had Bashir's lining up with Webb going to the flanker position on the previous snap, and that's when they were confused with the left side of the line coming up and a different voice on the cadence.
Well, you're going to see Bashir's lined up in a bunch of places. At the running back position, you're going to see him in the slot. You're going to see him at flank or at split end. They're moving him all around to get matchups. They think that getting the Bashir's the ball in space against anybody is their best deal.
Angus Quigley was a linebacker last year, sets up a tailback this year, and he is flanking on third and a dozen. Jordan Webb. Good pocket protection. Ton of time and tries to thread it through as it falls incomplete, trying to get it to Damon Patterson.
Well, Patterson and Bashir's are the guys that they want to get the football to. Watch, they're going to just take it right down, try to find a little seam in the zone. Nice little deal by Kansas State. Tight window. They got a nice drop out of their linebacker. Safeties reacted well and closed on the football. That was dicey right there.
Rojas punts it away. Back deep.
Whoa!
It's Tremaine Thompson. Man, but the fair catch on the short one. He'll take it in cleanly. At about the 34, near the 35-yard line. So great field position for the Wildcats.
And Kansas State came after it. Kansas had two punts blocked this year already, Joel. K-State came after that one big time.
So after picking up a first down, a punt by the Jayhawks. The Jayhawks will have problems offensively. Real problems with consistency. Carson Kaufman, you know the last name, his brother, an all Big 12 performer. Chase Kaufman, the tight end for the Missouri Tigers. They double up on the wide side of the field. Daniel Thomas is single behind Kaufman. Float the H-back into the backfield, and now in the flat, he is wide open. It's complete to Wilson, the motion man. And it's a short gain. Good recovery over there by Chris Harris at our Phillips Television starting lineup. Offensively, the experience and the anchors, the left guard, Kendall, and Weibert, the senior. A couple of guys that have started the last 2 years. Daniel Thomas, one of the very best in the nation, to the backfield with Braden Wilson, who we saw on the reception. Look at the backs and the receivers. And they're a little short-handed when it comes to the receivers making a miss. Daniel Thomas. Nifty move as he sprints out to the 44, short of the first down. Hogan Todu puts him down, the strong safety from Mesquite, Texas. Now our starting lineup defensively for the Jayhawks. They need a lot out of Laptap because they don't have a lot of experience in the front four. Dudley, honorable mention, all Big 12 last year, the strong side backer. And Chris Harris, he's over on the left side.
Great
quarterback with the experience.
Braden Wilson showing versatility, Joe. Catching and blocking in this series has been a stud.
Going to be third and a yard for the 44. Little option read. And Thomas won't get there. Cutting him off at the pass. What a play. Lubbock Smith.
Number eight, Daniel Thomas. Stopped by number one. Lubbock Smith.
That's a major accomplishment for this group defensively after they put and gave up 55 last week.
Carl Torbush is going to like that. The defensive coordinator, Bill Snyder, will hit you with the power running game, and then he'll run the option on you to make sure you don't blitz. Kansas played it perfectly defensively as a team.
42-yard average coming in for Ryan Doerr. Man back deep, it's Damon Patterson waiting with a fair catch, backpedaling, and slides down on a gamble at the 10. So a tap on the field, each hopefully got the jitters out of the way. They both had it offensively. See, they settle down. It's scoreless so far. Sims is in the backfield, ball security. They can't turn it over. They made mistakes and turned it over in that 55-7 loss to Baylor.
Four turnovers. You can't give it up four times.
It'll be Patterson in motion. Ben slamming it up. It is Sims, Childs pushing him back. So Sims, a true freshman from Irving, Texas, a Texas top 100 performer in high school. And very short that time, but they're going with a quick rhythm offense now. It's going to be Sims again, low this time. Across the 15, out to the 17. Third and three, Childs right up the middle, staying at home, the middle backer.
And Chuck Long likes this tempo. He says the young players are starting to get accustomed to the tempo in practice and being able to translate it and transfer it to the football field during games. Coming out with a much better start than they did in Waco against Baylor, shaking off the doldrums of that 55-7 defeat.
Power back is in there, Angus Quigley, a guy who's got a 5.5-yard average on his career. Lead three from the 17. And Webb throwing for it over the middle. It's available. It's Wilson for a first down across the 25. Almost like a little drag over the middle by the wide receiver. Childs brings him down from behind.
Well, one thing they were talking about, Joe, is getting better protection for Jordan Webb. Their quarterback's been sacked 15 times, been hit too many other times. They got to protect him.
It'll be Quigley. Huge hole up the middle as he slams it across the 35. Gain of six. Childs very busy as everything's right now between the hash marks.
Right. They're the softest, the most dangerous place to attack is right up the gut. The underbelly of the Kansas State defense right now is being pushed around by the Kansas offensive line.
Second and short, so six on first, need four. Swing pass, it's Bashirs in the flat, and he dives for the first down.
Uh-oh.
Flag late.
They may have called holding on the big fella Jeremiah Hatch out there in space. And it was after the play was by him, unnecessary. But that's what they want to do, get Beshears the ball in space. It's like a long lateral. It's like an extension of your run game to throw the ball in space to him on the edge.
Referee Matt Leffler with a call.
Personal foul. Clipping. On the offense. Number 77. That's a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Repeat. Second down.
They called Jeremiah Hatch not for a hold but for a clip. That was the guy that they got out in space in the big center. Trying to hustle and make a play, gets caught. Here he comes, working his way out, and watch. It's a clip, he hits him from behind, doesn't get the head in front, it's close though. Almost got his head in front of the body, but they ruled it a clip. The thing is, it was out of the tackle box. You can do that between the tackles. Once the defenders are in pursuit out of the tackle box, they get protected.
It's going to be, instead of the first down, across the 40, it's second and 19. And a flag.
That's a costly penalty, boy.
Grab the snap. Snap infraction. Number 67. 5-yard penalty. Remains second half.
Well, they're calling Slatnik 67. Prior to the snap, a little bit of a movement. Let's see if he moves right here. That's who they called it on. Now the center double-clutched it. It was Big Hatch double-clutched the football.
Out of the edge is Webb. Yeah, on the deflection, it falls incomplete. He was looking at Tim Beery, the tight end on the play. Reback appeared to get his hand on the ball. And we talked about the inexperience of, well, there's a redshirt freshman, Jordan Webb. We're talking about the true freshman, James Sims. They have gone with 17 different starters offensively. So trying to find continuity and consistency is difficult.
Yeah, it's the first year for the coaching staff at Turner Gill. They're still trying to find out what they have and what these guys can do. They're still getting familiar with each other expectation-wise.
Third and forever. Set up the screen. And at the feet with a flag down on the play of Angus Quigley. Was he held up, though?
Yeah,
because they threw
held.
It right there at the feet of Guidry.
He grabbed him coming out of the backfield.
If it's defensive holding, it's a first down.
I think they called it on Childs, 26, I believe. You know, the thing that you can't have happen like Jeremiah Hatch did, you can't let one bad play turn into two. You have a clipping penalty, and then the very next penalty, you double clutch the ball at center. Back-to-back penalties costing your team mega yards. You just can't do that. You have to compartmentalize. Forget about the one bad play. Don't let it turn into two.
And too many flags early in this contest for both sides.
Holding on the defense. Number 26. That's a 10-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
Mark it off and repeat third down. That'll take it up to the 25, more manageable now, as it's going to be third and 14.
Bill Snyder questioning the penalty. His team is the least penalized team in the Big 12 in terms of penalties and yards. Only 23 penalties, 197 yards. Puts him at 14th in the country in penalties, 17th in terms of yards. They do not self-destruct. He didn't like that call.
Trips on the bottom side, the wide side of the field for the Jayhawks. Ton of time, and Webb going for the bundle into double coverage. And not close, as battling his way downfield. It was Christian Matthews, covered well though. Hartman, the safety, was on top of the situation coming over.
Well, Kansas stopped themselves in that drive-by penalty as much as the Wildcats did. You know, you can't have two penalties in one series and expect to move the chains.
Well, they got into the hole with one first down because it started back at the 10, but they had another, the 41 that you're alluding to, Dave. And it cost him. Thompson waits for another punt. And Rojas sends it over to the boundary, trying to keep it away, and it's costly for them. It hurts the Jayhawks. It's a short one and great field position for the Wildcats when we come back after only a 27-yard punt. His parents feel very strong about the way he's appearing on national television tonight. We know that.
He was stressed out.
He's from the 46. K-State gets it for the second time. And coming back on the ball. Grabs made by Hilburn, the senior from New Braunfels, Texas. Yeah, after the good gain on first down, about five, our keys to the game. from Chrysler. Dave.
Well, they want to score first on the road, Joel. Some early success. They're 3-0 this year when they score first. They've won 85% of their games since 1990 when they do that. Special teams have to be special for them. They want to win the hidden yards and field position. They want to handle the hostile crowd. No penalties.
Out on the wing is Thompson. Had a good game for a first down. Quick strike to Tremaine Thompson, the redshirt freshman out of Jenks, Oklahoma.
Chris Harper had a heck of a block, a stock block on the perimeter. Chris Harper is the one that got that going. Watch number three right here in the white jersey. He got it going. Get in the edge. Get as much as you can. Get out of bounds. Everybody's running those bubble screens so effectively in college football. Very, very safe throw for the quarterback, and the wideouts are blocking so well. The coach is doing a great job of helping them sustain contact in space.
One for Baylor last week, went for better than 90 yards against Kansas, so you better try it against the Jayhawks. First down of the game. Thompson, same play exactly, gets a little kick out for the wide receiver, Chris Harper. And he's got about eight, almost nine of the play brought down by Patman.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago, the play you're talking about went 94 yards, Joel. Longest play in Baylor history.
Start for Kaufman, a solid one. He is 4 for 4 for 24 yards. And the first and 10 line is brought to you by Phillips Televisions. It's second and short, second and two now.
See, in those passes, those bubble screens get the quarterback's feet on the ground and build his confidence. They're easy completions.
Quarles and Thompson doubling up on the wide side. And now the fake by Kaufman. He only needs two, and he'll just get two. He got the first down by about a half a yard. So Carson Kaufman, the senior from Kansas City suburb of Peculiar, Missouri, moves the chains.
Well, what Carson Kaufman wants to do here is don't make a mistake. Now, don't put your team in jeopardy. Finds a lane. He can gain some positive yards. If you don't get the first down, live for another down to convert, but he does get the first down. Managing the game, that's what Carson Kaufman does a good job of.
We are halfway through the opening quarter in Lawrence, Kansas. Joel Myers, Dave Lapp, Jim Knox. Special edition of College Football Saturday at Concord. Thomas, good yardage. Inside the 30, down to the 25 for a gain of five. Tripped up by Ogunjodu. Strong safety.
Watch the linemen start to slant, and the run goes the other way. Sometimes you guess right, sometimes you guess wrong. Slant in the wrong direction. Kansas State just washes them out of there. You know, it's the luck of the draw. Sometimes the play call ends up perfectly designed into what the defense decides to do. The movement up front, linebackers didn't scrape over the top the other direction well enough.
Kaufman checking at the line. It almost looks like a single on the outside. Up against Jermaine Thompson, up the top of the screen. They'll go short side option. Nothing doing for Carson Kaufman. You don't exactly have a speed merchant at quarterback, and it's interesting, Dave, that they've decided to run two options like that with Carson Kaufman.
Yeah, and Laptad did a great job of holding the edge. There was nowhere for Carson Kaufman to go if he held it or pitched it. Laptad was outstanding on that snap, and now it becomes third and long. It's not an easy conversion right here for Kansas State. Very, very big third down opportunity for both teams.
Third and six from the 26. And changing the play, into the gun goes Kaufman with Daniel Thomas in the backfield. Fires short of the first down. Grab is made by Quarles. His first of the night, the senior from Aurora, Colorado. But Barfield on his back, Isaiah Barfield, immediately short of the first down by about a yard. And a good place kicker, so no decision to make. They'll go for the field goal.
Yeah, but you got to run the route past the chains. Quarles runs the route a little short. If you're going to run a hook pattern, make sure you hook up beyond the chains. You're a yard short. Don't run your pattern a yard short to completion. You still have to run out there and kick the field goal. Make sure you run your pattern deep enough.
It is going to be a 37-yard attempt, almost 38. Josh Sherry, 5 for 5 with a line of 48. And for the first point of the game, Sherry, and it's on its way, and it's good. So call it a 37-yarder for the senior from McCook, Nebraska. And the Wildcats strike first. 3-0 K-State, trying to go to 5-1 of the season on the road in Lawrence. Upstairs.
No question.
Cantelli will kick it away. Bashir's McDougal waiting back deep. And the Big 12's return leader, TJ Bashir's a yard into the end zone, will bring it out. Looking for a lane. and down very quickly with a 34-yard average coming in. He is shut down at about the 22. Rowletter was there on special teams play. So the Jayhawks, third time offensively, and they'll give him the 23-yard line. So let's see if they can mix things up a little bit. They've been able to pick up at least one first down on each of their first two possessions, but they couldn't get out of their own way on the last series where too many penalties.
Bill Snyder, who we just saw there, Joel, he's done something no other coach in college football history has done. He coached his son, Sean, and he's also coached his grandson on the football team now, Tate.
Sims ripped down very quickly. Rebeck, exceptional play. Getting there in a hurry, the senior, or making a junior from Oakville High School in the St. Louis area.
How about that? They call it Snyder Family Stadium. Coached his son, coached his grandson. It is definitely Snyder Stadium.
It is a family affair. Now off the play fake, it's batted right down once again. Coming up, Cadero Terrell. And he read it perfectly. The junior missed all of last season with an injury, playing well this year.
Well, if you're not going to get to the quarterback, get your hands up. Get your muckers up. Get them in the throwing lane. Nice job. Well, try to get Tiberius tight end on a little tight end screen.
And Dave, you've got a 6-foot quarterback. It's very similar. Todd Reising was barely 6 feet at the most.
Yeah, no question.
For Kansas, and that's the case for Jordan Webb. And now a timeout has been called.
Timeout. Kansas State.
So on a 3rd and 9 coming up for the Jayhawks. Clock has been running. There's some offensive experience at Kansas. Now it'll translate into wins because the program has been successful in recent years. Webb on 3rd and 9, floats it. It's Sims. He won't get the first down and make it Angus Quigley instead. Dropped immediately. It was Gerald Childs coming up on the play.
Joel, there's been a lot of 3rd and 6 or 7 and more, and very little 3rd and 4 or less. The defense has done a good job of putting the offenses in 3rd and long situations and getting off the football field as a result of that.
Tremaine Thompson waiting for the Alonzo Rojas punt. Very short one. Last one was only 27 yards.
Look at this split. These splits because you have these guys back here.
And on the low snap, another line drive wobbler. A break for the Jayhawks, though, with a good roll for Kansas. Out of bounds at the 28. Well, we were talking about Bill Snyder. You talked about the fact that, well, he's coached his son, his grandson. And now you look at the dean, yep. Bill Snyder, after a 2-year absence, back in his 19th season.
He and Joe Paterno, the only two coaches in college football that worked at the same institution for 18 years or more, never working anywhere else. Most coaching wins since 1990. Look where Bill Snyder's. Remember, 3 years off too, and there he is without 3 years to build that resume. Bill Snyder is a winner. Bill Snyder knows how to put together a football team, and he knows how to utilize their strengths.
Three of the top six: Mack Brown, Bill Snyder, Gary Pinkel of Missouri, Big 12 Conference. 1st and 10, and bottled up in the backfield. Daniel Thomas not escaping that time. Justin Springer catching up on the play.
Good job by the defensive front of Kansas of two-gapping Joel and giving absolutely no running lanes to Daniel Thomas. He's got great vision, so they did a good job at the point of attack and also the potential cutback lanes. Nowhere for Daniel Thomas to go.
Daniel Thomas comes in 7th in the nation, averaging 138 yards a contest. K-State, in fact, 210 yards a game on the ground, so it's magnified.
He's 5th as running backs, though. You had the two quarterbacks, Martinez from Nebraska and Robinson from Michigan. They're two of those top 7.
On the play fake, Kaufman looking at the fullback. Comes back the other way, and it's in and out of the hands of Thompson. Recovering and in a hurry, he had to recover. Tyler Patman.
Kaufman threw it the only place that his receiver could have a chance to make the play. A little naked bootleg. All the action goes to the left. Roll out by Lonesome to the right. That's a catchable football, and you got to secure that ball. You got to make that play. I don't know. No reason to jump. And Kaufman jumps after the incompletion, but his receiver didn't have to jump to catch that football.
So now 3rd and 10. They have not been able to exploit their best weapon, Daniel Thomas. On the edge, making a miss, and down the sideline he goes. It's Burles. And he's bumped out after a nifty move to get the first down and make it Thompson. 86, not 89. Ogunsotu got over there, but how about the first move by Tremaine Thompson, a burner at 5'7", 165.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, it missed tackles. You know, didn't want to have more than 10, and Patman misses, and he tried to just karate kick him. Just a little leg drive, a little to take him down. I mean, that's, you got to use the sideline as an extra defender, but man, you can't be falling away and kicking at him like you're in some kind of kung fu class.
Outside of the 35. Daniel Thomas making a mess. Boy, what vision. The awareness of the young man, the way he cut it back and didn't run himself out of the play, as you say all the time, Dave. Inside the 30, down to the 29, dropped there by Chris Harris.
When he gets his shoulder pad squared up to the line of scrimmage, El Lodo. What you have to do if you're Kansas defensively, make him turn his pads to the sideline and go east and west. When he's squared up to the line of scrimmage going north and south, wow.
Second and short after the gain of 7. On first down by Thomas. You figure you get more touches, especially 13 minutes into the game, and he has not had many opportunities so far. Bill Crowford on the stop route, Quarles has it. Man, he's got a first down in front of Barfield easily.
Quarles does a good job of lowering the shoulder there and getting some yards after catch and after contact. Pretty good effort by Quarles. Ball is on the money, and watch him lower the pads. Low man wins. It's all about leverage. And it just drives for as many yards as he possibly can. They're on the cusp of the red zone on the Kansas State Wildcats.
In it now, outside of the 17. It'll be first and 10 on a drive that started back at their 28. Thomas hits the hole in a hurry. Boy, for a big guy, does he just flash.
He's got some acceleration to him, Joel. He has definitely got some thrust. And watch it open up, and Springer saying, oh man, I got to take this guy and this big fullback on. That's just a heck of a lead block. And I'll tell you what, this young fullback, Braden Wilson, watch 37. Look at that. And look at this lane. Wow, that's a little lane right there for Thomas to take advantage of.
It's 6 on first down for Daniel Thomas. Now, throwing it out of the wing. It's complete inside the 10, down to the 9. It was Patman again taking care of Tremaine Thompson. And that's a guy that's difficult, as we saw earlier, to corral. So a good open field tackle.
Well, Kansas State wants to score 7 here and not settle for 3. The last 2 games, they've only been in the red zone 3 times, twice against Central Florida, once against Nebraska. So here they go in the red zone for the first time tonight against Kansas. They haven't been here often. They want to make sure they finalize and execute. Unbalanced.
You only need 2. Deep single, Daniel Thomas. Spins, but is short. There's good penetration into the backfield. Justin Springer wraps him up. A yard short of where he needed to go. He's outside of the 8, had to go inside the 7.
You're right, Joel. It starts with the defensive line. They have reestablished the line of scrimmage backwards and let those linebackers come downhill. Dorsey, number 92, got some nice penetration.
Right now, there is showing that they're going to go for it, but it's going to be a timeout and make it actually a break for K-State, because that was the last snap. They were thinking about using their timeout. They look at the clock into the first quarter. So another good drive, solid one right now. And Coral Torbush, the defensive coordinator for KU, he's got to organize things in a hurry with it deep in the Jayhawks end of the field. So an early 3-0 lead for the Wildcats in the showdown for the bragging rights of the Sunflower State, as you're watching Big 12 College Football Saturday Special Edition, presented by Phillips Televisions.
Reception by Thompson.
Now, first snap of the second quarter. It'll be 4th and a yard. Kaufman, he's got Wilson, the fullback, in there with Daniel Thomas. Coming up to the line. Wide receiver checking so they can hear it. Option. Kaufman can keep it. He will. And he's in. Touchdown, Kansas State.
Wow. The key block for Kansas State was the big fullback once again, Braden Wilson, 6'3", 254-pounder. Watch number 37 right here. Lead him around the corner. Turn back inside. Seal the edge. He didn't even have to really hit anybody. I mean, that's just good job at the point of attack on the perimeter. Tight ends, tackles, fullback. Well blocked. Coffin could have scored and touched football.
Cherry for the point after. And an early 10-point lead on the first snap of the second quarter for the Wildcats of K-State.
Take it up the perimeter. Nice job. Sustain on the edge. Excellent blocking. And Andre McDonald, 6'8", 277.
Just a few seconds in the second quarter, a 10-0 lead now for Kansas State, and it's Chase's little brother making the big play, Carson Kaufman.
Watch McDonald work with his tackle. The combination block, come off to the linebacker level. Outstanding. Double and rub to that linebacker level now. McDonald, 6'8", 277. Whoa! Oguntoro, he just takes him and kind of sashays him to the ground. I don't know if that's legal or not, but it wasn't called. But that's just securing the edge. That's a big old 6'8", 277 pounder.
Again, Telly kicking it away. A short one this time. Bashir's from the 6, designed to return it left. Can he turn the corner? Yes, and he gets a big block past the 25, outside of the 30. And knocked out of bounds, close to the 40-yard line. Time now for a Phillips Television game break as we head to the studio with Greg Wolf. Greg, that is the 7th out of 13 tries. 7th time the Bashir's has taken to 30 yards or more on return. So what a weapon when he does get to touch the football. Deshaun Sands in the backfield with Jordan Webb. And it's going to be Sands. Good hold the middle. There goes the ball. It's loose. It picked up. Coming the other way. The defensive back Zimmerman dropped inside the 30, the 25. Brazell Brown ripped it out and Ty Zimmerman, the true freshman from Junction City, Kansas, picking it up.
Ball security is a big factor in these football games, rivalry games. You cannot spit the bit. You have to hold on to the football. And that particular time, ball security, major, major issue. Short field for Kansas State. Let's see if there is. How much contact there is, how loosely you're holding the football. That's just a tremendous effort to just rip and rip it out of there. Brown does a fantastic job. 6'2", 284, just overwhelms and overpowers Sands at 5'7", 190. You got to get two hands on it when the big fella's ripping it out of there. Get the second hand on it.
Strong side, the wide side of the field. Thompson going away from that, though, on first down. And will it be a toss? Yes, Quarles on the reverse.
Oh.
Airborne. And he gets about 5. Good play defensively by Oguntodu. Otherwise, it's a huge game.
Oguntodu in the open field does a nice job in, you know, trying to go up and over. A little hurdle action. A good call. You know, there is some trickery and some trickeration to Bill Snyder's offense. It's not as bland and vanilla as people think. He will every once in a while open up the gadget box, and he did right there.
Is that in Webster's? Trickeration? It's outside of the 20 on second and about 5. Thomas with a block and trying to find somebody. Carson Kaufman, they were looking for people to block for him. It was that big a hole over to the right side down to the 11.
They are just outgapping and gashing Kansas up front. It's a little counter, pull the backside guard, watch him come around and pick up Springer. Ka-kunk. Now you have the lead blocker. Look at this lane. That's a Mack truck can go through that bad boy. I mean, you got to hit the right gaps. You have to get off blocks. Kansas State dominating up front right now.
First and 10 outside of the 11, looking for points off a turnover. 90 seconds into the second quarter. Huge hole over to the right side. Kaufman dives. It was Thomas who's a nice decoy over to the left side. And he's got another first down all the way to the 1.
And that's the thing. You're right, Joel. They want to make sure the ball doesn't go in Daniel Thomas's hands. Look at all the attention he draws. So Kaufman says, okay, I'll just hang on to the football. I did for a touchdown run. I'm going to continue to until you guys show me some respect and don't put all your attention on Daniel Thomas. I'll continue to crease you.
First and goal. Wilson in front of Thomas in the eye. Kaufman diving to the quarterback sneak. No indication yet. The linesman on our side says no. So it'll be second and goal, inches away.
Well, you got 4 cracks from the doorstep. If Kansas can somehow muster a defensive stand and make Kansas State kick a field goal here, that would be a win, considering the short field that they were put in with the turnover. But even just because your offense turns it over does not mean that you allow the opposition offense to drive down the field. You're going to try to bull your neck a little bit.
Kaufman Coming again. This time he should be in. He is. Touchdown, K-State.
Turnovers are poisonous. And Kansas State just dished a full spoonful to the Jayhawks. Sands obviously feels very badly about not securing the football. The offensive line gets a little bit of a surge. Up and over we go. Steven Johnson can't prevent Kaufman's big body from creasing the goal line at 6-2-2-0-4.
Josh Jerry out of the hold of Dorr. Man, a short field. Just what the doctor ordered for K-State. Bruzell Brown, don't forget, he created the opportunity. He wrestled it. Ripley
Hawks.
Cantelli kicking it away. Bashirs and McDougal once again. And
way out of bounds.
Yep. Not close. So it'll come out. And good field position once again for the Jayhawks. Although, I said that last time when they started on the good return by Bashirs.
Kick, you see, out of
bounds. Cantelli getting a word.
It'll be the 40. First down, Kansas.
Bill Snyder saying after the positive, now all of a sudden a negative because a short field for the opposition.
Carson Kaufman has been dynamic tonight. Very accurate throwing the football. A lot of bubble screens and help there by wideout making defensive back miss on the perimeter. The wide receiver getting extra yards after catch. And then he's been excellent on the edge. Decision making with the option.
And Dave, it's short intermediate throws, high percentages,
sure,
for Kaufman. I like what they're doing.
Get his confidence up.
Ton of time for Webb. And deep down the middle, he was available and he missed Damon Batterson. And he was available for a while.
And here you see a redshirt freshman quarterback continually trying to go deep with the football. Be more patient. Take some of the short intermediate stuff that might be available to you. You can't score 17 points in one play. Don't press. Just do your job. Take what's there. Don't put your team in any kind of jeopardy. The game's not over. You got to answer with a score here, but be smart.
And it seems like Kaufman hasn't thrown anything over 10 to 15 yards.
Right.
Out of the gun. Webb slings it well. It's Beery is tied in. And he has popped after a gain of 6 out of the 46. Ty Zimmerman, the true freshman who picked up that fumble, a former high school quarterback.
Different.
On the hit.
Yeah, difference is Kaufman's a senior. This is a redshirt freshman. His first experience in this rivalry. That's a good man to go to, though. Your tight end, a possession receiver in the middle of the football field. Beery's been around the block a few times. Good catch.
Third and four, and this is key. You're a young team. You're already down by 17. It could head south in a hurry. Only needs four and gets four. Had to have it. Jonathan Wilson is best receiver, most experienced out of Houston. Gets it in front of Jarrell Childs.
Well, you can see the throwing arm that Jordan Webb has. In fact, Chuck Long told me that this quarterback has the best throwing arm that he has coached. That's high praise when you think of all the quarterbacks that Chuck Long has coached, considering his stay at Oklahoma. Very lively arm. He ran the spread offense in high school. Jordan Webb, he has good talent. He just needs some experience. He can't drill a hole in his head and give it to him. He needs reps.
So they were desperate for the first down. They get it. Now on the play fake and the delay. Isolation and inside the 10, incomplete. It looked like his wide receiver Matthews was going to be able to come up with it. Steven Harrison on the coverage.
And Bill Snyder kind of breathing a heavy sigh of relief on the sideline because he did have inside position, had the ball, lost possession of it between his legs, could not quite bring it in, gets two hands on it. Harrison trying to rip at it as he tries to tuck it to the body. Watch, gets two hands on it, bring it to the body, and the rake of the right arm by Harrison was the difference. Pulled that right hand off the football.
Quick timeout call.
Timeout. Kansas.
Man, he definitely saw something. It was confusing, the offense, because they still had 10 in the play clock to check it off. 17-0 K-State, 4 minutes into the second 15. Massachusetts, Dairy Queen, right after the game. We're covered. We're absolutely covered.
Fast food heaven.
Health food. James Sims in the backfield. Will he get it? Yep, and he won't get much. Popped right to the original line of scrimmage.
Very big possession, as we talked about. Kansas has to answer. Kansas State has a three-score lead with 10 minutes and 30 seconds plus to play in this first half. Got to slice into this lead.
That was Brandon Harrell on the stick, and boy, does he show up on film over the first few games.
He'll be in
for
a camp.
Kansas State.
He'll be in a camp on Sunday.
Third down and long. Man, firing it to Wilson. Now, interesting proposition, down by 17. So much time left, even in the first half. You need two for the first down. David Garrett on the coverage.
He's got James Sims going in to go for it. He says, we got to continue this drive. Big fourth down play right here. Too long for a field goal. If you try to punt and it goes in the end zone, you don't even pick up 20 yards of field position. So deciding to try to go for it on fourth down and extend the drive.
Can they get two? That's all they need. Moving the pocket by design. Now Webb in trouble. Can he create? No. And lucky that he held onto the ball. It could have been popped away going the other way. David Garrett on his back, who made the previous play.
David Garrett, number 27. This is a little Tasmanian devil right here. 5'8", 176 pounds. Not the size of the fight and the dog. It's a dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight and the dog. And here comes a dog that'll fight you. Garrett tries the tomahawk chop. He almost lost it, almost punched it out of there. Good job by Jordan Webb showing some strength in the hand and forearm to secure that football, because Garrett did just as your coach.
And it was fourth down, so once it's on the ground, but the point is, it could be headed the other way like we saw Ty Zimmerman.
Right, exactly. When it's on the ground, it's anybody's play. It's a live ball, and you're taught to turn the football over if you're a defensive football player. Everybody practices drills, strip the football drills, tip drills for interceptions, and he exercised that drill and translated it to the field.
On first down, Kaufman looking over the middle and going deep over the middle. Grab is made inside the 25. Chris Harper winning the jump ball. He had the intermediate route. Andre McDonald underneath, wide open between the seams, his tight end. They pulled it off on Greg Brown.
Well, a contested catch. Kansas couldn't make the contested catch. Kansas State does. That's just catching the ball at the apex and out fighting the defender for the football. Look at Harper box out. Use the body. Put your body between the player and the football, and he boxed Greg Brown out. And on the flip side of it, Kansas couldn't execute that same play. It was knocked away.
Kaufman now 9 of 10 for 115 yards. Talk about a perfect beginning for him. Huge hole. Daniel Thomas making a miss. Seen that a few times, haven't we? He's got 10, and he's right at the first down marker. Brought down by Justin Springer.
Showing some patience is Daniel Thomas, knowing that he's a target. Look at this. Look, in space. Wow. Trying to tackle him one-on-one in space. He's giving you the limp leg. You know, this is a 230-pound guy that has moves in space like that. It's just dynamic runner. It's only his 18th game running the football.
The limp leg gets him entry.
There you go.
Chris Harris.
Give it, take it away.
Thomas again. Blasting his way up the middle inside the 10 on first down, close to the 9 for 3. Dropped by Richard Johnson, the junior from the state capital, Jefferson City, Missouri.
In Daniel Thomas's first 17 games, he's rushed for 100 yards or more 8 times. He hits 100 yards tonight. 50% of his starts at the running back position will have 100 yards. He's a baby in terms of reps at the running back position. His upside potential is off the charts.
He is 6'2", 230 pounds. You try to bring him down. He gets into the zone read, and nobody's going to get him. Touchdown, Kansas State.
Daniel Thomas had not rushed for a touchdown in 2 football games. That streak is done. And Coach Snyder, you couldn't tell by his expression if he's up 23-0 or down 23-0. Totally focused. Look at the action. Good blocking up front, sustained blocks. Again, the Wildcats score 2 rushing touchdowns without a fingernail laid on them. Kansas State is dominating up front. These guys are scoring in touch football.
Cherry for the point after. So with that run, Daniel Thomas goes over 2,000 career yards rushing, only the 7th in Wildcat history to accomplish that. And does he ever do it in style? A 9-yard touchdown run and a 24-0 lead for K-State. They are truly purple people eaters tonight, aren't they? The Wildcats of Kansas State up 24-0. nice to have a running back with the talent of Daniel Thomas. And now in the record books with better than 2,000 career rushing yards.
And the big boys up front, Joel, take a bow. You know, they got a lot of experience. Look at all those starts. And the most experience they gained the last couple of weeks. Central Florida's defense, pretty good. Nebraska's off the charts. You know, they took a spanking against Nebraska, but it makes you better. You learn lessons playing against that high caliber of competition. Carries over to the next week, things become a little easier. They are dominating tonight.
Bashir is waiting for the kick, and he will take it at the 7. Brought the last one back to the 40. Tripped up and goes tumbling down with a flag down to the play. Across the 25 of the 26.
Well, here's the man, Daniel Thomas. He imposes his will on defenses. He finishes every run hard. Corey Dillon I saw at his best, and Daniel Thomas finishes runs like Corey Dillon used to. Protects the football. He's a good understanding of ball security. He has vision. He has patience. He's got a lot going on for himself. And again, this is only his 18th start at the running back position.
That's a 10-yard penalty. First down, Kansas.
Yeah, flag on the play on the return. So an illegal block. And as we've spent time, and I spent time 2-3 weeks ago with Daniel Thomas, a real gentleman. And in fact, he was with the offensive linemen, Kendall and Weibert. We spent about 15-20 minutes with those two as well.
Right.
And they just are real comfortable with what they're doing right now as a group, and they've got a nice rhythm going on that offensive line.
Well, Daniel Thomas is a humble guy, Joel, and Daniel Thomas is not one that searches the spotlight. He appreciates his offensive line.
And he didn't want to play defense. Oklahoma recruited him, and a number of teams recruited him like Oklahoma, elite teams, but they wanted to play defense. Now they do it on the end around of the reverse play. Trying to get more touches for DJ Bashirs, but there's Zimmerman over there making a big play again like he did in the fumble recovery. Noxie, what's going on?
Ogden with Daniel Thomas as well, Joe. The running back he likes to pattern his style after is no other than Adrian Peterson. He kind of resembles Adrian Peterson in his running style, just hard nose coming right at you.
He does. He's an all-day kind of guy, boy. He runs the same speed first or fourth quarter. Great durability.
Webb out on the edge. Man, takes it in. Bradley McDougal. Short gain brought down by Sweeney as he gets it across the 10, back out to the 12.
Joel, as I look at this football game, I think Baylor's speed stunned Kansas. They still haven't recovered. Nebraska's speed stunned Kansas State. They've recovered and adjusted. Kansas State is playing faster than Kansas is, and Kansas State is on the road, and they look like they're running the football field a lot quicker than Kansas is.
I want to get back to that thought in just a moment. Webb in trouble and up for grabs. It's incomplete. Almost picked off. Stephen Harrison had a better shot at it. Put it this way, is Nebraska's quarterback faster than the running backs for Kansas?
Oh, absolutely. Well, here at Kansas State, last week they gave up 6 plays that totaled 313 yards. 6 plays. They gave up 5 touchdowns of 35 yards or longer to Nebraska. Big splits by Nebraska. Martinez distorted your football geometry, and Kansas State was stunned, but they've adjusted.
Rojas with the punt. Thompson had a very good punt. Thompson, tailor-made hop. And a little bit of a lane. Can he keep making a mess? Yes, he will, but he runs into his own man. Still going close to the midfield stripe. If he doesn't hit his own man, he may be gone down the sideline. Prince Candy on the stop. Triple header next Saturday. And it can't come soon enough, can it? It'll all start in the Big 12. Missouri and Texas A&M, just 2 days away.
Yes.
In the middle of Pac-10 showdown, Cal and USC. And in the nightcap, Iowa State taking on number 6 national title contender, Oklahoma. It all starts at 12 Eastern, 9 Pacific. Well, how about the Rucker following Kaufman, now Agnew from Missouri, and they had some tight ends.
Oh, and this guy's 6'6", and big, and Fuller's an unbelievably dynamic receiver. Going to have fun on Saturday checking that battle out.
Wildcats with a 49. Kaufman looking for the bundle, and now he'll play it safe. He'll go down across the 49 and the 48, a gain of 3. He was looking deep for Chris Harper and then brought it back when he saw the safety coming over as well.
And really, Bill Snyder is kind of going for the jugular a little bit. I mean, he's going for the big plays. I mean, I think he realizes his football team has a speed advantage. He was on the other end of it last week against Nebraska. He doesn't like that. And now he's got an opportunity to take the upper hand in this one, and Bill Snyder will take the upper hand on you.
It'll be second and long. Low throw, take it in. Thompson down to a knee. Boy, sure hands though, wasn't it? Down to the 44. And it'll be third and three in front of Barfield.
Again, Kaufman doing a good job of throwing the ball accurately, and they're making good calls. Made his receiver work a little hard for that one. That's a very, very good catch. Helped the quarterback out right there, securing that football when you don't even need the contact when your knee is down and college football plays dead.
Great hands displayed by Tremaine Thompson, a redshirt freshman.
Shoestring catch.
Now Kaufman. Options available, and not a bad one. Daniel Thomas, first down inside the 35. He had two crossing over the middle. He had Harper available if he wanted to go back to the far side, but Thomas was wide open.
Now remember this, in junior college, Daniel Thomas was a quarterback. So he's got great hands. Very, very soft hands, just plucks that football. Now he's in space and he's a handful. You know, get the ball in his hands as many ways as you can, as many times as you can, because that is a workhorse right there. He craves opportunity.
5 minutes to play in the half with the running clock. William Powell taking over in the backfield. And look at William Powell make a miss. Their big kick returner finally spun down by Patrick Dorsey, but at the next level. He got 8-9 yards.
Well, watch the fullback, Graydon Wilson, the big 250-pounder, 37 again right here. Hit, sustained finish, pretty good job right there getting the edge. You know, they had Rock Cartwright. Remember old Rock? And now they have Braden Wilson. This kid is a big old stud, 6'3", 254, and he brings it.
Second and a yard. And almost out of sequence there. Powell short of the first down. It almost looked like the line lifted up, like everything was out of rhythm.
Right. Yeah, it looked like the center was a little bit late snapping the football. But, you know, what Bill Snyder's going on now, he runs the power game between the tackles. You start to crowd the box, you run the option to make sure that you defend the width of the field horizontally. Then when you start doing all that, then you creep to the line of scrimmage, he throws it over your head. And he knows exactly when to do each of it. He's always one page ahead of you in the book.
Need a yard. Thomas is there. You think he's got it?
Yep.
Easily. It's still going.
Whoa.
And you talk about yards after contact by sheer effort. They're like pistons churning his legs.
That's a man right there. Limping a little bit as he comes back to the huddle. But now you hit it up in there. Keep your pad level low and keep driving those powerful legs. Look at the knee drive. Look at the high knee action. Drive, drive, drive. Sometimes you can get caught, though, and get twisted funny in those piles. And Daniel Thomas, that last little drive with his left foot, kind of got caught in an awkward position. Hopefully he's okay.
That'll bring the senior from Duncanville, Texas, back in. 5'9", 205-pound William Powell.
Not a bad option.
He'll get it. Nothing available. Yes, looking at the cutback. That was taken away. It'll be second and 10. Kevin Young staying at home, the defensive end of the play. Redshirt freshman from Olathe, Kansas. First and 10 line is brought to you by Phillips Televisions. So keeping it on the ground, the clock is moving. Inside of 250 to play in the half.
William Powell, Joel, all he's doing is averaging 9.6 a carry. Not bad.
Shift the tight end. Tannehill, strong side, wide side. And little seal over the right side. There's Daniel Thomas. Boy, he was hurt.
Yeah.
Inside the 15, down the 13. He gets about 7. Dropped by the lap dad.
Look at this tight little pirouette. We have a 230-pound ballerina right here. Watch this little tight pirouette in space. Plant that foot and spin. Nice. Keep the pads square to the line of scrimmage. Get upfield for more yards. Again, has not played the running back position a very long time. It's his 18th start. Seems like he's been a lot more the way he carries it.
Short field helps, doesn't it? Started to their own 49. Need 3 on third down. After the play fake and the chip, back in the end zone. Touchdown, K-State and Tannehill.
Number 80, Travis Tannehill.
Okay, we've seen Daniel Thomas run it. We've seen him catch it. Great blitz pickup right there. They faked the football to him, took the blitzer down. gave Kaufman an opportunity to throw it down the field, vision unimpeded. What do you do without the football if you're a superstar? Watch him, fake, chop, nice. Open lane, touchdown.
Josh Cherry, disbelief on the face of the Jayhawk fans in the stands. How many were going to be here in the second half? 31 to nothing, Kansas State. And what a start, Chase Kaufman, or Carson Kaufman, 12 of 13, 141 yards.
Yeah.
But all percentage passes, very high percentages.
No question, and the running game has established the play-action pass, and Daniel Thomas does a great job after the fake, and he hits his 250-pound tight end, Travis Tannehill, the back corner of the end zone, 6'3", 250.
Downstairs we go. He's going to keep it. Jim Knox.
Okay, thank you, Joe. Coming up on the Geico Halftime Show with Greg Wolf, we will take a look at West Virginia and South Florida. That's right. Also, a preview of Big 12 contest going on this weekend and break down this first half. Guys, a familiar face right here. Senior PGA golfer right here.
Yes.
Jim Palmer. Look at this guy.
All right. After last week, I didn't know if we'd do this. Way to go, Cats.
You're looking good right now, Jim. Joel.
Hey, Knoxie, we spent time with Jim Colbert a few weeks back at K-State. Saw his magnificent layout right off campus.
Really?
And Jim, when he's not living in La Quinta, California, Rancho Mirage, he's in Manhattan, Kansas. That's where he lives.
Can he straighten out my slice, Joel?
There's no help for your game. Bashir waits. High short one at the 12. Can he light a fire under the Jayhawks? No. Put down. And an outstanding job for Kansas State by Lemur.
Well, you go back 2 weeks ago, Kansas was outscored 55-7. You add this, it's 86-7 in six quarters of football. That's Oogie Oogie right there.
Five-yard mark off after the fact. So instead of the ball, and actually, will they bring it back? Yes, they'll get another opportunity to kick it over, and I don't blame him with a return man like Bashir's.
And you saw the perfectionist, the professor, Bill Snyder, hates penalties. His team is the least penalized team in terms of penalties and yards in the conference, and they're top 20 in both areas in the country. Bill Snyder hates these kind of mental errors. And check out the offsides. Who's jumping here? Look like that's the guilty party. That could be another candidate. You have to time it up a little bit better. You can't cross the line before the kicker releases the football down the field.
So move it back five. Dan Cantelli will kick it away once again. Bashir's from the 18 this time. Design return left. Running out of racing room. But gets it out across the 35. Real balance, though. We talked about Daniel Thomas. Carson Kaufman set it up with the short early passes and the high percentage completion rate. 141 yards passing, 106 yards rushing, 247 right now for the K-State Wildcats compared to just 77 for the Jayhawks.
Well, Kansas State has gotten their running game going, and they're running play action passing, naked bootlegs, all those kind of things off of that run action. And they have Kansas between a rock and a hard place. Those linebackers right now don't know what's happening.
Webb on first down. And it's complete, but his tight end is sandwiched over there. Jim Beery, the junior from Omaha. And a short gain of about four to the 40-yard line. And they get some points. Going into the locker room.
Second and six at the 40.
After the play fake. Flushed out. Will run for it and pay for it. He's put down at the 43.
Well, Jordan Webb had been sacked 15 times going into this football game and hit countless other times. They wanted to protect him a little bit better than they've been able to do tonight. When you can't run the football and you're down 31 points, these guys will pin their ears back and get you.
Need three in the flat. Diving, he won't get there. Angus quickly, and now K-State with two timeouts. Do they want to stop the clock? Let it roll. Already up 31 to nothing. And Webb looking over the sideline on fourth and short. It'll be fourth and two. And a timeout is called by Kansas.
There's a 7-second differential between play clock and game clock right now.
Well, we thought going in, let's face it, we thought it was going to be fairly even, but if there was potential for one of the two teams to capitalize in this fashion, it was K-State because of the experience of Carson Kaufman and Daniel Thomas, and especially the big lugs in the middle, the center and the two guards for right. K-State.
And they have. They've controlled the tempo of the football game up front. And again, like I said, last week, they got embarrassed against Nebraska, but they learned, and really Nebraska raised the bar for them in terms of level of performance. Kansas State responded to what Nebraska did to them, and they adjusted to the speed and tempo of Nebraska. So the speed and tempo tonight of Kansas is easy for them to deal with. On the flip side of it, Kansas still has not adjusted to what Baylor did to them down in Waco. Kansas State's doing the same thing to them tonight. They have not made that adjustment. The clock in their heads and bodies still haven't adjusted. And Kaufman, one completion short of perfection. And he's been great on the ground as well.
He's got two rushing touchdowns. And they get the first down. So quickly scrambles over to the left side. The senior from Cleburne, Texas, a former linebacker. He was running back, then a linebacker, looking for more speed. They put him back at tailback. And now, inside of 20 seconds, play for the midfield strike. Can Webb find a way to get some points on the board? They still have two timeouts, one timeout on the board. His wide receiver fell down on the comeback. He was trying to get Bradley McDougal, and his feet came out from under him, the sophomore from Dublin, Ohio.
Yep, he planted and tried to sink his hips, get in and out of the cut on a little comeback route. Went to the turf.
Well, if they can get a completion inside the 35, they still have a timeout up. Maybe three. Anything at this juncture for Kansas. It has been that bad on their home field. Just about 30 minutes into this game. Moving the pocket by design. Webb. And almost a great grab. After the deflection off Wilson's hand, he was close to a pick for David Garrett.
I love Garrett. He's a hybrid. We saw him rushing the quarterback and tomahawking, chopping the ball out of Jordan Webb's hands. Now you see him 20 yards down the field in coverage. He is a true hybrid safety slash linebacker. And here's a guy that's got a big heart. 5'8", 176. He's in there taking people on in the running game, and he's able to run in coverage. He's a valuable guy.
And he's one of the reasons they like to open in a 4-2-5 so he can be on the field. Webb down the middle. That'll be the end of the half. McDougal breaks the tackle, and that'll do it as he's spun down by Zimmerman. And what a first half for Zimmerman as well. Sure-handed tackle there when he broke the initial hit. So a 31-0 lead at the half, and they are stunned in Lawrence, Kansas, the home of the Kansas Jayhawks. So the Wildcats doing everything and anything they wanted. Man, there's got to be some disbelief even on their side of the field right now.
Yeah, and really, it's only one turnover, Joel. You know, they 31 points. I mean, it's only one takeaway. Kansas State dominated.
Downstairs, Jim Knox.
Okay, thank you very much, Joel. Coach, you got to be extremely pleased. You guys came out and really just dominated on both sides of the football.
Good evening.
We're playing better than we played a week ago, I can assure you that.
Talk about Carson Kaufman, and also talk about Daniel Thomas, what they're doing right now, the nice 1-2 punch.
Well, Carson has done a nice job throwing the ball. I think he's close to being as good as he can play at throwing it. And Daniel is, you know, Daniel just hasn't got himself in the open yet, but he's made some plays for us.
Appreciate the time. Thank you, Coach. Halftime in Lawrence, Kansas with the score. All Kansas State, 31-0. When we return, we'll join Greg Wood for the GEICO Halftime Show. Stay with us.